doing her right.
Let the good times roll.
Theme song, Hulk Hogan.
Yep.
Adopted my song as his theme song, and I went, oh man, I thought I wrote like the most patriotic song of all time, and then here it is, a wrestler's theme song. But then I later on I found out, as it time went on and on, Barack Obama used it to unveil his birth certificate. That's right. And every time that guitar riff played, that birth certificate went in and out of the screen like that. 22 million hits. Then they got worried about paying me. So they took it down and started at one again. Got 22 million hits again. So they owe me a lot of money. I call at the Democratic National Committee to get paid. Well, we're going to play it for you right now, and it goes just like this.
Thank you.
I speak for all you guys when I say that. I am a real American. Now, well, 57 years ago, like I said on the little promo, I was blessed and I was asked to record a song called My Girl Sloopy. Now, I sang it, and then I went, you know what? This song never says, My Girl Sloopy. So the title should actually be what it says, which is, Hang On Sloopy! This song all the way back in 1965. We had hot shot producers from New York City, and they said, you know what, it's too long. So what we gotta do is we gotta cut out that second verse. So that means every single time you guys have heard this song throughout your whole life, you've been cheated out of the second verse. So I come here tonight to write a long-standing injustice. I'm here tonight to set the record straight. But once and for all, and you know why? Because the buck stops right here, boy. Something goes a registration. It's as old as the hill. Come on, come on, the one that got it all started for me. And I'm still here today. I tell people about that song and I go, you know, I recorded this song probably was before you were born. And most of the time, that's correct. Most of the time, that's correct. But I've also been part of a lot of great records over the years. I'm going to play a couple right now. I helped to discover the guy that sang this and produced it, played in the band for a while, and it goes like this. Song.
Hell yeah!
That you very seldom hear played from a three-piece guitar band. So we're going to break all the rules tonight.
Yeah!
And we're going to play it for you right now. And it goes like this. In a laboratory once upon a time, at work was a doctor named Frankenstein. Yeah. a platinum record, yeah. Well, Grammy. Lied about that. It came in second place to a song called Hocus Pocus by Focus, which they cheated because they yodeled. It wasn't an instrumental. They cheated. I want my Grammy.
Well, Grammy.
I'm sure he's got it too.
I'm just going to say this for my friend Neil Giraldo. I wish I could play all night long, but I only got time for one more song.
Thank you.
how we all forget about birthdays as time goes on. I forgot about that, Kent.
Yes, well, may I say something else? Ladies and gentlemen, this man has worked with Alice Cooper, Johnny and Edgar Winter.
Oh, and we won't go there. I should introduce you to my great band. Over there on bass guitar, joining us again for the first time in about 20 years, Mr. Eddie Self on the bass guitar. And back here in the back, the guy that's been so vocal, our intrepid drummer, Mr. Ken Mutino. Now I'm going to play this song.
Thank you.